We are in Karlsruhe. Today is the first round of Bundesliga Championship, and we are with Maxim Vasilagrav, who just won a game. Congratulations to the victory.
Thank you.
Maybe you would like to show something from your game and tell us how was it?
Yeah, I didn't expect this line exactly. So Andreas went for the open willow pass, which I didn't really expect. So I played a line I had already against Shah Medvedev, something like, I think, 2 years ago. Of course, we went already to this position against Shah, and I have one bishop on knight against rook and two pawns. Black has a very nice center, but I'm just hoping to get a playable game, and of course not. The position is very difficult to play for both sides because of the imbalances. So Andreas went queen d6, and here I thought for a while because I couldn't remember what I wanted, and I played something that I don't know if it works so well, but at least it gave some sort of playable position for both sides. So here I think I went knight to g3, c6 was played, and after queen to e2, I think, king to h8. Anyway, here I didn't know how to play. I just didn't want to play bishop e3 because of h6, knight f3, bishop g4, so that's why I went bishop d2, but I'm not sure it was correct. So h6, wait, what was played? I think h6 was played, yes, and here, at first I wanted knight f3, but e4 is good for black, so I went rook e1. And here I thought I had a nice draw, but of course Andreas went e4, which is a good move because after pawn takes, queen takes, queen takes, rook takes. He has to go rook f7, bishop g5, rook a7. And here if I take the knight, it's gonna be a draw, but I have knight takes f5, knight takes, rook e8, king h7, and now bishop c2. Diamond exchange down after g6, but there's no way to get to the e-file because of my bishop on g5. Something like rook e6, certain g4, then h4. It looks very, very dangerous. But after e4, I suddenly thought I might just be worse. But anyway, now my point was that I go queen h5, so I set a knight f7, bishop g6. Here I was not sure between queen h3 and queen h4, but I went queen h3 because I wanted to threaten knight e6 or queen e6, so I went knight f5, take, take. And here after queen h4, I think queen e7 was just a miscalculation. I mean, any sort of move would have been quite dangerous for both sides. So I don't know, something like after queen f6, I have rook f1, of course, which is the reason for queen e7, but at least it doesn't allow knight f3. You cannot go king g8 because of knight e4, but any sort of move should be very double-edged, like rook e8. But after queen e7, knight f3, suddenly it's a lot of trouble. You have to exchange queens, and after bishop h7, g3. The point is after c5, there's bishop e3, because I cannot take because of the pin. After rook d8, but bishop e3 just attacks both pawns, and it's very bad. I mean, so in the game, it went g5, knight g2, king g7 to play against h4, and bishop e3, bishop f5, and now I think I went h4, king to g6, and I think I started with bishop d1. In any case, it looks terribly dangerous. I threatened all sorts of things. So bishop h3 was played. But here, Yeah, I went h5, king h7, bishop c5, rook f7, knight e3, and it just, there's just no way to defend. I threat on g4, bishop d7, and now after knight g4, rook e8, bishop d4, it's written all sorts of things. No, actually, I played rook f1 to keep this bishop on c5 to prevent any sort of rook maneuver. And here, Andreas lost on time, but anyway, I'm gonna collect some pawns on the queen side, and I have all the pawns under control and all the files, any counterplay under control, so I think it's totally winning.
Yeah, well done, congratulations one more time. And how does it really feel to touch pieces again after such a long break?
Yeah, it's a very good feeling. I mean, I've had a break of 6 months, that never happened before in my life, but it's quite difficult to readjust, and that's why also I wanted to play this tournament, to get back some feelings for over the board chess before the candidates resume.
And how are you satisfied with conditions in this event? Were your expectations satisfied about how it's organized here?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, there's no way to avoid, you know, any sort of risk, but I think we're doing a good job so far. To the organizers are doing a very good job so far to minimize any risk of a big cluster. I mean, that would be a shame. I know that playing chess is one of the riskiest activities you can do in these COVID times, but I hope that it's gonna all go smoothly, and so far I think the organizers and the players are doing a good job to make this event secure as possible.
Thank you. And what are your thoughts about the candidates tournament, about its continuation in November?
Yeah, I'm ready to play any time. So I knew that there was a possibility that we resume as soon as the situation permits it. I think in other sports like tennis, basketball, everything has started resuming. So I mean, with the proper sanitary conditions, I don't see why we shouldn't resume this event.
Thank you very much for your time, and good luck in the Bundesliga.
Thank you very much.